Ken Brown, the man playing bass and guitar and flute on our right that hasn't been introduced yet. This is Ken Brown, by the way. Was doing a Celtic guitar workshop at the Fox Valley Folk Festival. Sitting next to me, yeah, you know, Ken Perlman and Joseph Sobel.
Ooh. And stellar lineup.
We're supposed to be Celtic guitar twiddles, you know. And, I played this following slow air, and Ken is sitting there. Well, you know, you want back up? No is an acceptable answer. And I said, well, no, actually, I don't mind if you back me up at all. And he did such a nice job as the second guitar that, and we had such a good time hanging out that he mistakenly suggested next time you come up to Canada and have any time to kill, you could stay at my house.
Yeah. So we did.
We had a.
Believe me, we know how to kill time.
Yeah. And so we went up to his studio that he had in Fergus, Ontario at the time, and we tried doing actually Dink's song that you heard Margaret singing earlier, and he somehow wound up as being producer on our newest recording.
It's not my fault.
All he did was walk out of the control booth as Phil and I were messing around with Dink's and said, you're recording that song. And we said, what? It's not even in our repertoire. And he said, you're recording that song. And I don't know, it was Pavlovian response. We just kept recording every time he said, record that song.
And anyway, this is a tune called Oh, All the Airts. If you're a Stan Rogers fan, it's the tune that was used for the Scarborough Settlers Lament, except in 4/4 times instead of 3/4 for you theory buffs. And with a B part that was never heard on the song, but it's just a pretty part. And then we're going to go into a Strathspey. That's a kind of reel that has hiccups in it. And if you're, for those of you unfamiliar with the Strathspey genre of Scottish fiddle music, and that tune will be called the Sprig of Ivy, and then we're going to follow that with a reel, the kind with the hiccups taken out of it. He's had a glass of water by then, because it's called the Peerie, Hoose, Ahint, the Burn, which is the Scots dialect of the little cabin by the crick. It'll be a test. The dog walks into a bar.
Bartender says we don't serve dogs here and shoots the dog in the foot. 6 weeks later, that dog is back with a 10-gallon hat and a pair of six guns.
I'm looking for the man what shot my paw.
That should answer the question, if these folks have any sense of shame at all?
No. Man walks into a bar.
Oh.
Bartender says...
Oh, wrong joke.
Bartender says...
Sir, you need a tie to be in this establishment.
A tie? Get real. It's 2 in the afternoon. It's 3 hours before your upwardly mobile clientele comes in for happy hour. I just want one quiet beer. Can't I have a beer and then I'll leave?
No. Rules are rules. You must have something tied around your neck with a knot in it.
Anything?
This time of day, I'll take anything.
Well, a fella goes out to his car, digs around. The only thing he can find that is long enough to go around his neck is a set of jumper cables. He ties them in a nice knot, comes back in, and confronts the bartender. Well?
Not sure about this. I'll have to ask the bouncer.
Well, all right. But don't try to start anything.
No. Did we say no shame? We said no shame.